animals and plants, gametes undergo dramatic differentiation in addition to meiosis. The female gamete, the egg cell, is one of the biggest cells in the body. The male gamete, the sperm cell, is the smallest cell in the body. The only property common to egg and sperm cells is that both are haploid. This also sets them apart from all other cells in the body that are diploid. In most cases, males produce sperms all the time. Females, in contrast, produce eggs at specific times. In many species, eggs are produced seasonally once a year. In others, egg production is regulated by internal or external stimuli. In women, eggs are produced in a 28-day cycle. During the menstrual cycle, a single egg is produced and the uterus prepares for pregnancy. The cycle starts with the secretion of the follicle-stimulating hormone, the FSH, from the pituitary gland in the brain. FSH stimulates several follicles to grow and develop and to secrete the estrogen hormone. The rise in the level of estrogen signals the pituitary gland to stop secreting FSH and to start secreting the luteinizing hormone, the LH. LH triggers ovulation, which is the release of the egg from the follicle in the ovary to the fallopian tubes. This happens 10 to 16 days from the first day of the cycle. Normally, in each cycle, only one egg is produced from one of the two ovaries. The follicle that releases the ovule becomes a corpus luteum that secretes the progesterone hormone. This hormone induces the uterus lining to thicken and to fill up with blood and nutrients in preparation for the implantation of a fertilized egg. Pregnancy can only occur if the egg becomes fertilized within 24 hours of ovulation. From the millions of sperm that start the journey to the egg, only few reach the finishing line. From these, only a single sperm will succeed in penetrating the egg and fertilizing it. Once fertilized, the egg immediately starts a process that prevents any further sperm cells from entering. Fertilization triggers the final stages of egg cell meiosis and the first cell divisions of the embryo. The embryo implants in the uterus 5 days after fertilization, when it consists of about 100 cells. If no fertilization takes place, the levels of progesterone and estrogen fall, leading to menstruation. Menstruation is the shedding of the lining of the uterus and secretion of blood and tissues through the cervix. Subsequently, the menstrual cycle restarts again.
Each of the thousands of follicles in the ovaries contains a single undifferentiated egg. Follicles start to develop already in the fetus, so that upon birth, a girl has already all her eggs. These eggs are arrested in the first meiotic division and will remain like this until the girl reaches puberty in her teens. Upon puberty, a single egg will mature every 28 days until menopause in her late 40s, except of course during pregnancies. We learned that during meiosis 4 cells are produced. However, the meiosis of the eggs yields only a single egg. When an egg that was arrested for many years starts at long last to mature, it finishes the first meiotic division. This division yields a big egg and a small polar body that will degenerate. The egg will complete the second meiotic division only if and when it gets fertilized by a sperm cell. This second division also yields a big egg and a second polar body that will also degenerate. We got these videos from the IVF clinic we will visit later on in the course. In this video, you can see how a recently fertilized egg undergoes the second meiotic division. At the bottom right, you can see the polar body that resulted from this division. In this video, we see an egg with its two polar bodies and how they are carefully collected for genetic analysis to prevent the birth of a baby carrying a hereditary disease.